If there's one thing to be learned from watching Channel 9's Ninja Warrior, it's that I really need to exercise more. But one contestant on the show is going from strength to strength and has just made the top eight. Olivia Vivian is taking on the men and showing them what strength and determination can do. Have a look.
Can she be the first female into the grand final number two? Look at it go!
Olivia Vivian's about to put away into stage two of the 2020 Ninja Warrior.
She's done it! Olivia Vivian, you're a legend!
You are remarkable, Olivia Vivian! She's crying! We're crying!
Well done, babe!
Take my pulse. Woo-hoo! Get me an ambulance. Someone help me. What just happened?
Olivia Vivian has just posted her best result in the history of Australian Ninja Warrior.
It gives you chills. It gives you tears in the eyes.
Olivia, you are the standout star. Welcome to the Ben Robin Robbo Show.
Oh, thanks so much for having me, guys. Appreciate it.
Look, congratulations on making the top eight. It's really, it's a pretty impressive feat when you consider the competition you've been up against.
Oh, yes. Man, that course was so tough. You know, it's stage one of the grand finals taken me out the last 2 years. So racing that clock is never an easy feat. And I'm so stoked to be in stage two, finally.
So tell me, you've competed, you know, in courses that even the male competitors couldn't do. What's that down to? Is it down to dedication? Is it down to strength or both or just because girls are better?
I think, you know, going into this season, I wasn't exactly in my top form. So I did a lot more visualization, actually. And I think that really helped sort of figuring out a plan of what you might do through the obstacle before you actually do it, because we don't get to try it. We don't get to test it.
Really?
We see it, get told the rules. Oh. About yep. 2 hours before we start, and that's all we got. So
when we see you on there, that's the first time you've actually done that call. Wow, I didn't know that. That's amazing. That makes your achievement even more amazing. Well done.
It makes it very nerve-wracking, that's for sure. Yeah.
So you've been competing against your partner, Ben Paulson, but he's also been your coach, you know, pushing you through. Is it a weird dynamic with both of you trying to win the competition?
First of all, it's weird that people think he's my coach. I know he says stuff to me when he's on the sideline, but in all honesty, I can't hear a damn word he's saying.
But it certainly comes across like he's coaching you through. He's certainly offering you a lot of support when you're on those courses.
Yeah, we do have a really good communication where we ask each other, what do you want to hear from me on the side? You know, if I am going to stand there and yell. I like to be told to remind to sort of breathe and catch my breath and feel my confidence and stuff like that. So, you know, it is, it's a dynamic I'm actually really grateful for, especially during the show as COVID came in and restrictions started sort of hammering down and they were changing every 24 hours. To have Ben on my sideline and to be on his was actually a really nice support. And I know
I also think that, you know, being a good sports person is about being competitive. However, he's also made it through to the top eight. Would things have been awkward at home if he hadn't made it to the top eight?
Yeah, well, last year he didn't make it past the semifinals and I went to the grand final and it was hard because I wanted to celebrate, but at the same time, part of me was really devastated that he'd splashed out. So to be there actually both together was amazing. I would have been heartbroken if he wasn't, just like that would be reciprocated. But he's a tough competitor. And because we have been training together, I know how ready he is for it this year.
Well, it was crazy because you two actually went up against each other in a trial this year, which was just to hit that button. So that was crazy. Look, but let's talk about you because you are the first female in Australia to make it to the grand final stage two of Australian Ninja Warrior after narrowly missing out last year. Do you think you can go all the way? I mean, I know you know the results of this, but let's assume you don't. Do you feel you can go the way? I don't know the result.
Yeah, like I've been training for it this year. I think season three, I came in with the mentality, like, why don't I go for the top? Why don't I set my goal up really high? But I actually wasn't training the rope climb. And that stage four, Mount Midoriyama, is no joke. It's ridiculous. And the rope's like so much thicker than just an average rope, which makes it even harder to hold on. So it was one thing to say, I'm going to win it. I want to win it. And not train the rope. So this year, both Ben and I have been training that rope, because what's the point of saying I'm going to try win the show if you're not actually training the last obstacle? So I know I'm capable. It's just going to come down to the mentality and the mental side when you're up there and performing, because, it's mentally very brutal.
Well, I think all of Australia is on your side, because you are just a crackerjack, and it's thrilling to watch you on the show. Mm. So good luck. I hope you win. I would love to see you take it out. Thanks for coming on the Ben Robin Robbo Show.
Thank you so much, guys, for having me. Enjoy the rest of your day.
It's the Ben Robin Robbo